So first of all, let me congratulate you to take the option of to take the dare to civils exam. First of all, how do you feel about civils exam among all other competitive exams in India? Yes. Is it the topmost or any other is there? Which is tougher than this? Yes. Yes. So you have chosen for the topmost competitive exam. What does it mean? Your hard work, your concentration, your level of preparation also in that way only. In that way only. So once you have chosen for civils, means you are ready to work hard. First of all, at the same time, entire concentration should be on the preparation. No other deviations. Why? Because you have chosen the topmost competitive exam of India. Do you agree with me? Yes. So especially coming to civils means. Now you are ready to work hard. You cannot say, I want to prepare very lightly. I don't want to take hard work. I don't want to work hard. These things will not work out. Okay? So first of all, when you have chosen this, automatically you have chosen for entire hard work and you are ready to work hard. First, you have to keep it in the mind like that. Always, whenever you are waking up in the morning, yes, I have chosen civils, so I have to prepare well. I should be second to none. In that way, you have to think of. This is required for preparation of civils, whatever optional you take, whatever you take. Why? Because this is the topmost competitive exam. You have chosen for that. Right. Then, this session, I think further 1 hour to 1.5 hour, we will discuss about the choosing of optional. There are so many optionals. So how to choose an optional, first of all? That you have to decide, that you have to know how to choose the optional, first of all. What are the criteria for choosing optional? Yes, can you share me? What are the criteria? Interest, self-interest should be there, okay. Yes. Availability of material, okay.
Recent trends,
okay.
Simple to other optionals.
What do you mean by that?
Comparing options.
Mm.
Some options are simple, right?
Mm. Okay, let us see what are the requirements to decide on an optional. Okay, so how to select optional, first of all? What are the factors to be considered for selection of optionals? Yes, first thing is self-interest. First of all, in that optional, you should be interested. You should have the interest. You forget about the how hard it is, how big the syllabus is there, how the trend is there. Beyond all these things, first of all, you should have interest in that. Without having interest in the subject, don't put the bolt. If anybody comes?
No.
Okay, right. Right. So you should have the interest, first of all. See, not only optional or exam, whatever it may be, normally human tendency should be whatever work you have taken up, in that work you have to show the interest. If you are doing without interest any work, it will be wasteful only. Even though you are successful, but it won't yield the result. Without interest, if you are doing, it won't yield the result. Even your diet also, you observe the difference. whenever you are taking diet with more interest and whenever you are taking without interest, you observe the difference between those two. That diet also will be useful only if it is with interest. So similarly, while optional selection also, there should be first of all interest. You should be interested about that. Then only you can prepare well. Without interest, if you say, suppose you are a science graduate, you have chosen, say, public administration. Public administration definitely is a good optional. I don't say that it is not a good optional, but your interest should be there. If you are not interested at all for the in the government activities and over the politics and all, and you have chosen public administration for the purpose of studies only, then you cannot go success. So first of all, self-interest should be there. Then next factor is knowledge in the subject. What is your previous knowledge in the subject? That will help you. See, once if we have the knowledge and we are confident that knowledge is helping me in preparing the subject, then automatically self-satisfaction will come. So if you have the knowledge in the subject, you are utilizing that knowledge for preparation, then the preparation will be more fruitful when compared to the without knowledge. If you choose a new subject, of course, you can do it with the hard work. But if you compare with that, where you have the knowledge, then it will be more easy. See, knowledge in the subject automatically increases the interest also. It increases the self-interest also. If you have the knowledge in the subject, then automatically it increases the interest also. So first of all, interest should be there. Then knowledge in the subject. In which subject you are having knowledge? In which subject you have studied in your graduation? That plays a major role. Okay? Then UPSC's consideration about the subject. What is your ultimate aim actually for choosing optional? What is the ultimate aim for choosing optional?
To clear merits.
Yes?
To clear merits.
Yes. To be successful in the examination, UPSC. Okay? So how UPSC treats, that is also more important. How UPSC treats about the subject, that is also more important. Okay? So deep, that's what you are saying, trends. How the trend is being followed, how UPSC is treating when you are attending for interview after clearing this prelims and mains, when you are attending for interview, then depending on your optional also, they will give you some value to you. What optional you have taken, at what level you are performing, depending on that also, UPSC will consider. So UPSC's consideration also more important to select is as optional. Okay? Then availability of resources. So what are the resources required, first of all? What are the resources required? Yes. You come to the front, that will be better. You come to the front. So that so what are the resources required, first of all? Yes, what are the resources required for any subject? Proper books should be there. Proper guidance should be available. Proper material should be available. At the same time?
Test series.
So material. So availability of resources. Suppose you are from engineering background and you are selected for electrical engineering. I think resources available are very less when compared to other options. Like that. So what are the availability of resources? That also you have to think of while selecting the optionals. So availability of suitable teacher at suitable time, that is more important. At our suitable time, the suitable teacher should be there to guide you properly, to cover the subject. So depending on all these things, you have to select the optional. Then our main aim is to score more. Whatever knowledge we obtain, that is required. But our main goal is scoring. So which optional is more scoring? in which option we can score better, that you have to think of. Depending on these things only, you have to select the optional. Then time for preparation, whether the available time is sufficient or not. Whatever time remained for us for the preparation, whether that timer is available or not, how to plan that. Is it possible to plan within that time? All these things you have to consider to select an optional. Then way of preparation, how to prepare. It differs from subject to subject, from optional to optional. Way of preparation will differ. So depending on all these factors, your self-interest, your knowledge, how UPSC considers, and then availability of resources, proper guidance giving teacher, then scoring, all these things will play a major role for selection of optional. So these are the things, not only for mathematics, for any optional, these are the things you have to consider. By considering all these things, you have to select the optional. Okay? Then self-assessment. That also should be there. That should be possible, first of all. In any option you have selected, you should be able to assess yourself whether my preparation is sufficient or not, whether my knowledge is sufficient or not, whether the time is sufficient or not, after performance, after preparation, whether it is sufficient or not. You should be able to assess yourself. That is self-assessment. Yes, I have prepared well. Yes, now I am confident. That confidence should be created. Such subject you have to select as an optional. See, so all these factors will work out for any optional, not only for mathematics. As I am from mathematics, I may say mathematics is having all these things, but you have to think of on your perspective also. Your way of thinking, your way of approach, your way of thinking, all these are also play a major role. If you are not interested in any optional, please don't choose it for the sake of scoring. That will not yield the good result. That interest should be there, self-interest should be there. Without interest, if you select it only for the purpose of examination work, I study and forget. If you think like that, like in your academics. In academics, what we do? Each and every subject is to be prepared. It's a must. Otherwise, you cannot clear the, you cannot get the good marks in your degree. So even though without interest also we have studied, that's a must. But here, while selecting option, that self-interest plays a major role. Okay? So these are the things to be considered for selection of any optional. Any other things I have forgotten and you want to add? Yes? Any other things? So I hope I have covered each and every aspect. So all these aspects, you have to think of to select any object. Okay? Then coming to mathematics optional. That is the crux of today's session. Coming to mathematics option, whether all these are possible or not. Whether all these are possible or not, let us think of. Before discussing that, let us have a discussion, your views about the mathematics option. What are your apprehensions regarding mathematics optional? What are your apprehensions, you tell me? What do you think of about mathematics options? Yes, tell me. Yes, what do you think of about mathematics option? Yes, tell me, even online also can be, you can also share it. You will be allowed to unmute yourself now, so that you unmute and you can tell. Just tell me, what do you think of what do you, what is your apprehension? What is your view regarding mathematics optional? Yes? Scoring. Let me write pros and cons. So let us say pros here. Cons here. So scoring. So you feel that it is more scoring or less scoring? Scoring. So you are taking that as a pros, right? What else?
Less time to finish the syllabus.
Less time to finish the syllabus. Do you agree with that? When compared to other options, I'm frankly saying that it takes more time to finish the syllabus. That I can write as cons. More time required for preparation. Interest, it will be on the individuals. Yes, formula based. So it will be easy to understand. So formula based, you are saying as a pros. What are the cons? You first tell me. What do you hear about the mathematics option? Why so many people are afraid of taking mathematics, even though with background, mathematics background also?
Vast
syllabus. Vast syllabus. Okay.
People think that mathematics is a tough subject.
It's a tough subject. Okay. What else?
Question to answer.
It have unique answer. So it's a pro. Am I right? Unique answers. Right.
Forgetting.
That means you will not forget or you will forget?
Forget. Need more practice.
Needs more practice. Okay. Needs more practice.
Understanding is tough.
Understanding is it easy or tough?
Tough
to understand. Okay. Yes, what else? More theoretical based maths is there in the syllabus. More theoretical based, okay. More theory is there, okay. Yes. Anything else?
Less faculty.
Oh. Faculty availability is a problem, right? See, these are all your views only, right? Any other? Yes. Okay. Yes, from online, anybody, if you want to share anything, you can unmute and tell me. Or even you can type in the chat also. Okay. Let me come to these your views about mathematics. Yes, please. Somebody talk, no? Okay, let him talk more. One second. Right. More time is required. That is your first thing you have told. Yes, I do agree with that. When compared with other optionals, mathematics, for completion of mathematics optional syllabus, it takes more time. I do agree with that. It takes minimum 6 to 7 months. If you have 6 to 7 months time to prepare for optional, then only you have to choose mathematics. But the thing is, this more time is covered in your revision. Any other optional, if you want to revise, it will take minimum 3/4 to half of your first preparation time. Suppose any optional you have taken, you have prepared within 4 months, let me say. You have completed entire syllabus within 4 months. Then if you want to revise it, it will take another 3 months. Definitely it will take another 3 months. Whereas in mathematics, if you practice well for 6 to 7 months, then for revision, it will take only maximum 1 month. Then which is better? See, here the problem is, with other options, what happens is, it's a type of mug up. Do you agree with it or not? In my view, it's a type of mug up. You have to read, and again, read only. Then only you can remember the things. Whereas in mathematics, it's not like that. Once you have practiced for 6 to 7 months to complete the syllabus, then the revision, it will take at the most maximum 20 to 30 days, that's all. Within those 20 to 30 days, you can revise it. Just if you revise the formula and what the procedure, that's enough. You have already done it. That is the advantage here. At the same time, more time to spend. See, whatever time you more you spend in mathematics, that much of yield will be there in the form of scoring. Whereas in other options, there is a saturation point. Beyond the saturation point, you cannot expect. Even you work hard also, you get the same score. Suppose you have finished the entire thing. Then if you practice more also, scoring will not be improved. Whereas in mathematics, it's not like that. Whatever time you have spent, more time you spend, more revision, more times you revise, it will yield the score. This is the maximum scoring optional among all the optionals. That much I can take sure. Similarly, maximum time taking also. When maximum scoring is there, automatically time spending is worth. Time spending for that is worth. In other options, if you want to spend more time also, you cannot increase the score like this. That is the advantage of mathematics. Okay? Then vast syllabus. Yes, vast syllabus. But actually, in the entire syllabus, 80% is covered in your graduation. 80% syllabus is covered in your graduation, either in engineering or BSc. One more thing, if you have mathematics as a subject in your graduation, then only you have to opt for maths. Otherwise, I don't suggest you. Suppose you are a BCom computers, but you have full knowledge of intermediate, and you have more interest in mathematics. But due to other circumstances, you have studied BA or BCom, and you stood first in that also. You can work hard. You can analytically work also. Even then, I don't suggest. You should have the previous knowledge. In the graduation, you should have mathematics as a subject. At the same time, you should not have any fear about mathematics subject. If you are having fear about mathematics subject, then I don't suggest. You may not be efficient, but you should not have a fear. When I am afraid of mathematics and I take mathematics, then result will not be yielded. So that syllabus, even though it is more syllabus, 80% is already covered in your subject. Only theoretical part is not covered for engineering students, and for graduation, BSc graduation students, some other topics are not covered. especially physics chapters are there. Those physics chapters are covered in your physics actually, in your engineering or BSc. But for BA maths, okay, it is not covered. That physics chapters also not covered as mathematics. It covered as physics, so you have to work in a other way to complete the syllabus. That should be there. So that syllabus, whatever you are saying, more syllabus is there. 80% is already covered. Remaining is 20%. Now you compare that 20% with the other new subject syllabus, which is more. Entire new subject, if you select, you want to complete the entire syllabus, which is more new for you, completely new. You have to start from scratch. But this entire syllabus is already 80% covered in your graduation. But of course, even though it is covered, again you have to work out. But it's not so hard. That's why I am telling you, it takes more time. 6 to 7 months you have to take time for completion. Like other options, you cannot complete within 4 months. If you completely leave everything and sit on only mathematics, then you can complete in 4 months, but it's not a good preparation. First, you have to concentrate on prelims. Along with that, you have to prepare for optionals. So in that way, you have to spend minimum 6 to 7 months. Then only you can complete. But after that, at any point of time, you can revise it within 20 to 30 days. Whereas that is not possible with other optionals. Then, tough. See, whenever you are feeling tough, civils exam itself is tough. You have chosen for the tough only. So I should not be afraid of toughness. You have chosen the topmost competitive exam of India. Then how can you be afraid of toughness? And particularly in mathematics, if you understand, it will be very easy. If you have interest with understanding, then it will be very easy. If you don't have interest and if you don't have the concept, sequential you are not following, then it is very tough. Already 80% covered in the graduation. So when you are dealing with that, then the toughness will not bother you. The toughness will not bother you. Okay? Then needs more practice. While preparing, it needs more practice, but while revision, it needs very less practice. Okay? Then tough to understand. I don't agree with that. It's not tough to understand. Only thing is proper concentration, analytic mind should be there. As a science graduate or engineering graduate, always we think of analytically only. We never try to mug up anything. That is our habit actually. But one thing I will surely say you, like in your academic studies, just waking up just 2 months before exams and then prepare, that process will not work out for civils. Normally, 90% of the students, even more than that also, what we do while preparing for academics? Just 2 months before exam only, we start preparation, serious preparation. That to answer the exam, to get through the examination, to get the more marks in the examination. That is our aim, not the subject. Most of the students. But here that should not be there. That should not be the case even for, whatever it may be, any optional. In civils exam, that case should not be there. If you want to prepare in that way only, as it is habitual from childhood onwards, that habit should be removed. You have to work hard. Always you have to think about tomorrow is the exam. How you prepare in the same way you have to prepare today also. 1 year before exam also you have to prepare like that only. As if you are having an exam tomorrow only. That should be the preparation process. Then only you can succeed in the prelims, civils. Okay? Right. Then more theory. Yes, theoretical part is there. For BSc mathematics, that is habituated for them. For engineering graduates, the theory is new. But actually, especially the area analysis, abstract algebra, linear algebra, these three are more theoretical. Real analysis is nothing but basic to calculus, which we are using very From the plus two onwards, you are using calculus completely. Even in engineering or graduation also, you have used complete calculus. So there is a basic for that. So you can understand easily. Once you have to habituate with the analytic mind, that should be there. Okay, faculty availability, where it is available, then you have to choose it. Faculty is not more number of faculty is not available when compared to other optionals. Okay, so this is what you have told. Then coming to pros, scoring, yes, formula based, so automatically we can apply easily. Then unique answer, yes, this is more important. When compared to any other optional, after writing the exam, I cannot say, yes, I will get 10 out of 10 in any other optional. But in mathematics, you can say it. After writing exam, yes, for this question, for 10 out of 10, I will get it. For 20 out of 20, I can get it. Like that, we can say, why? Because it is unique answer. The answer cannot be expanded or cannot be shrinked. In any other optional, if you write a good, neatly you have presented, there may be other person who have presented more neatly than you. So to give more marks to him, they will reduce marks to you. Even though your answer is perfect, your answer, whatever you have written is correct. But some other persons have written more neatly. Neatly in this, not only in the writing, presented very neatly. He has presented two more points. That is possible in other optionals. Whereas in mathematics, it is not like that. Everything is step by step. So that possibility is there. So you can assess yourself also. That is the most advantageous. Okay? So any other apprehensions you are having? Yes. So major...
Sir,
Yes, tell me.
Sir, while doing the steps in between, in middle steps or at the last steps, we made a mistake, then how much marks you are deducting, sir?
See, normally the process also have some marks. So definitely, even though you won't get the final answer, whatever steps you have given, for that the marks will be given. No zero marks will be given. If everything is correct, only answer is mistake or some step is missing like that. At the same time, while answering also, I will tell you occasion, while answering also, anything, whatever hypothesis is there, any theorem statement is there, the statement you have to mention there. Then they will give full marks.
Oh, yes.
Okay?
Oh, okay. Right. Thank you.
Right. Yes. Any other things regarding... Definitely, it is having more syllabus, but maximum covered in your previous studies. Yes, any other queries? So I think I could answer your apprehensions. Okay, any other thing is there? So let me tell my view regarding mathematics optional. Yes, everybody told that is more syllabus, huge syllabus is there, but it is static. Syllabus is not changed for several years and it won't be changed for several years also. Whatever syllabus is there, that is fixed. Whereas most of the other optionals is not fixed. Time to time it will change. And in that syllabus also, most of the part is covered in your graduation. Okay? Static syllabus, that is the main advantage of mathematics. The analytical study. I can surely say only mathematics is the most analytical study subject. Your mental capacity will improve. You will not be fed up with reading and reading. Why? Because in mathematics, we never read at all. We always work out. Whereas other optionals, even your general studies, other options, entire preparation for civils is most of the part reading. writing for practice actually. Whereas mathematics, practice itself is writing only. Preparation itself is writing only. You cannot read it. So analytically you will start preparation. So this analytic preparation will help you to keep your mind awake. See, always for any preparation, first of all, our mind should be ready for that. Your mass preparation will keep your mind ready for anything. It's not my words, it's the words of some psychologists only. If you prepare mathematics, then preparation of other subject will be easy for you. Why? Because our mind will be ready for that. Way of thinking will be analytical. So analytical study, that will be habituated to you. That is there. Okay? Then continuation of your subject in graduation. Definitely. Whatever subject is there in your graduation, 80% is that only. Remaining 20% is continuation, extension. Frankly speaking, in some questions, in some chapters, it is just above graduation and below post-graduation. Our level of preparation should be just above graduation and below post-graduation. Most of the questions are graduation level only. In any papers, previous papers also we take up, from that also, minimum 60 to 70% from your graduation level only you will find the questions. If you compare your annual exams for your previous degree papers and you compare your civils papers, most of the questions tally. Standard questions only. Okay? Self-satisfaction. How could we arrive at self-satisfaction? When we are making use of our knowledge, I feel satisfied. Yes, whatever I have learned from childhood is not being wasted. It is yielding result here. I am utilizing my knowledge here. So I could derive satisfaction from preparation. Whereas in any new subject, if you want to prepare, what happens? Self-interest is to be created. Then if you are successful, then only you can derive the self-satisfaction. Whereas in mathematics, already it is habituated for me. I am utilizing my knowledge for further preparation. So whatever learned from the childhood is not being wasted. That is my self-satisfaction. If you do any work with self-satisfaction, that will definitely yield a good result. If you select any other optional which is completely new for you, then you cannot derive this self-satisfaction very easily. Whereas in mathematics, you can derive the self-satisfaction very easily. That is there. Then high scoring, yes. Mathematics is the only option after writing exam, how many marks I can get, at least approximately I can tell. In other optionals, you cannot estimate so easily. Whatever you write, other person may write more better than you. Then your marks will be decreased. That is examiner nature it is. While valuing the paper, to give more marks to other person, you have to reduce the other person's. He cannot give 11 marks out of 10. And normally, cutoff point will be maximum 7 to 8 only for 10 in other optionals. Not more than 70% to 80%, nobody will give in other optionals. If you write a neat essay also, at the most they can give 8 marks out of 10. They cannot give 10 out of 10 in any other optionals. Only in engineering optionals and mathematics optionals, they will give full marks. Why? Because there is nothing to improve it. There is nothing to expand it. Nothing is missed in that. Then they will give full marks. The only optional which you can get full marks, it is possible, is only mathematics. For a question I have written neatly in other optional, I can expect at the most 7 marks, 7 out of 10. Whereas in mathematics, I can expect 10 out of 10. In that way, the scoring is available. Okay? Then, specific answers. Yes. There is no confusion at all. If a question is there, if a theorem is there, that proof is unique. Nobody can delete any one step from that. Nobody can add any other step from that. specific answer. There is no confusion at all. In other options, what happens? Suppose in any other option, if something is written, then you will doubt whether I have to give data or not, whether I have to mention previous history or not, whether I have to give the present practice or not. So whether which is legal or not, whether I have to mention or not, all these confusions will be there. Whereas in mathematics, no confusion. If you know the answer, you can write. If you don't know the answer, you cannot. Okay? So specific answers. Nobody can expand it or shrink it. Then easy revision. Yes, I already told you. Preparation takes more time, but revision takes very less time. See, why I am particular about revision is, normally, very normally what we see is, clearing civils exam in the first attempt itself is very less percentage. Am I right? So, of course, we wish everybody to clear it off in first attempt only. For that only you have to try. But by mistake, the second, third attempt is to be required. Then revision of other optionals is a hell. Definitely, I can say. Whereas mathematics revision is very easy. That is possible only in mathematics. Why? Because nothing is expanded. Static syllabus. Syllabus is not, even after 1 year, after 10 years also, same syllabus will be there. From 10 years also, for the last 10 years also, the same syllabus. Same chapters, same questions. Same formula. You cannot change the formula. Whereas in other options, what happens? It depends on situation. It depends on circumstances. It depends on syllabus. Syllabus also will vary. Whereas in mathematics, it won't vary. So specific answers, that's why it is easy to revise also. Easy revision is possible. Less competition. If you compare with the persons choosing mathematics and choosing other optionals, least percentage is mathematics. Least percentage of candidates opting for mathematics is, optional is mathematics optional. So what is the advantage of less competition? Yes, can you tell me? What is the advantage of less competition? Less number of persons. While valuation of papers itself, thousands of, yes, please. Yes. I won't follow you. Okay. See, while valuation also, what happens? Thousands of papers are there. Thousands of candidates are there. So their view of valuation is selection or elimination. Elimination is their view. See, the exam, in the most of the competitive exams, what happens is they value it for elimination, not for selection. How to eliminate? In that view, they will value it. Whereas in academics, no. How to pass him? How to get good marks? In that view only, they will have evaluation. Evaluation will be done. But in competitive exams, not like that. How to eliminate is the major issue there. So whenever mathematics optional is there, the papers are very less. Candidates are very less. So always he try to award some marks, not to reduce some marks. Psychology, human psychology. Psychologically, automatically, the examiner will feel, okay, I need not eliminate so many persons. That is the advantage of less competition. Okay? Then sharp mind. Yes. When you are working with mathematics, automatically your mind will be sharpened. Definitely. I think nobody will deny it. When you are working with mathematics, your mind will be sharpened. Or you will feel sleepy. Normally, while preparing mathematics, we never feel sleepy. If you are preparing for other subjects, which you have to read and you have to write unseen, all these things, then we feel very sleepy. So that sharp mind will fetch you to do anything. Not only preparation of my subject, even in your life also, it will help you. Most of the mathematicians work very sharply. even though they don't get good marks in other subjects, but they take decisions very sharply. Why? Because they have a sharp mind. That is there. Then creates the best identity in interview. Yes, I told you, while selection of options, one of the issue is UPSC's consideration. Whenever a person is attending for the interview, suppose you are one among the thousands of persons who have opted for one optional, then the interviewer also will say, okay, among 10,000 members, he is one of the optional. But if you are mathematics, you opted for mathematics, like that he will think of. Why? Because very less candidates opt for maths. So the value will be more in the interview. See, most of the times interview is for your appearance and the value the interviewer is giving to you. It depends on both the things. So whenever you are appearing for interview with mathematics optional, then you got some opinion, positive opinion among the interviewers. That is possible. Why? Because less number of candidates. Very less number of candidates will be there. At the same time, most of the candidates afraid of mathematics optional. Similarly, interviewers also in that view only. And he is in that view. He had opted for mathematics. He is very dare. With that opinion, he will start the interview. Okay, that will fetch there. Increased confidence levels. See, the confidence levels can be increased most by the mathematics only than compared to other optionals. Due to the factors, answer is specific, our mind is sharp. All these things will increase our confidence levels. I can prepare with confidence. But only thing is, while finishing off, you have to spend more time. That should be there. First preparation, it will take more time. I also agree with that. Without, if you are not able to understand, if you are not able to give that much of time for preparation, then I don't suggest. If you are able to give that much of time for mathematics, then only you can take mathematics.
Sir, how much time should we require to prepare mathematics?
What is that? How many?
Sir, how much duration it is required to prepare for mathematics, sir? Sir, I have completed M1, M2 and M3 in M4 in engineering. Can I opt for mathematics, sir?
What is your graduation? Graduation,
sir, engineering, sir, I have done.
Engineering. So, are you afraid of mathematics?
No, sir. I was strong at PUC only. I did not take pure science for PCM. So I'm in doubt whether in engineering I have studied M1, M2, and M3 and M4, sir.
You came to engineering through polytechnic?
What, sir? No, you... PUC from state PUC college, sir.
Okay, there you don't have mathematics.
There I have, sir. I know differentiation, integration, partial derivatives also, I know, calculus also.
That's
I know.
The only thing everybody is having also in PUC. See, in graduation, if you covered mathematics and you are having interest in mathematics and you have no fear about mathematics, then I will suggest you to take mathematics. Okay, is it clear?
Yes, sir. Sir, to prepare for it, how many duration?
It will take 6 to 7 months.
How many months?
6 to 7 months it will take for first preparation. You have to prepare.
I will try it then.
Okay, then.
Okay, sir. So, will you only teach, sir?
Yes. Good yield of hard work. See.
Sir?
Yes, please.
So, if I am going to appearing for this year, then this course will be complete before this month, January.
I couldn't follow you.
Sir, am I audible?
Yes.
Sir, if I am going to appearing for this month, this year, this
that attempt, is 2021.
Yeah, so it will be complete on this year also.
2021, and so far you have not started preparation.
Yeah, I have started also, but I am asking about this course.
I don't think it is possible. Why? Because in October only you are having prelims and after that immediately mains will be there. So this time may not be sufficient. Minimum 6 to 7 months first time preparation should be there for maths optional. If you are confident that you have already studied entire graduation syllabus properly and you are still having it in your mind and you are capable of doing that, then okay, you can try. But I don't suggest.
Sir, I did my MSc in mathematics also.
Then okay, if you are a postgraduate in mathematics, then it is easy for you. You can just revision. It will be revision only.
Okay, sir.
Sir,
I am asking about this.
Yes.
I am asking about this course. I mean, the duration of this course. It will be complete before January.
Probably February, if may, right? Up to February, okay. January or February.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
And if you are a postgraduate in mathematics, then you can try for that. No problem. You just observe the syllabus. Whatever is covered, entire in your graduation process, everything is covered except physics. So you can proceed, no problem.
Okay.
Now, good yield of hard work. See, I want to work very hard. For that only I have selected UPSC. Otherwise, if I don't want to work hard, I never select my UPSC. Civils exam, you want to prepare means you are ready to work hard. Okay. In other optionals, if you want to work more hard work also, the yield may not be compared to mathematics, yield may not be the same ratio. Once you prepared well, then you are practicing well. If you spend half of the time when compared to other optionals, your score will be double, your increase in the score will be double than that other optional. So more hard work, more yield is possible here. Whereas in other options, less hard work, less marks, more hard work, average marks, not the more marks. I am talking in terms of increase in maths, increase in scoring. Whatever hard work you put, that you cannot guarantee that it can increase 10% of your original marks. Once you have prepared, then you are adding hard work for practicing it. Then whatever hard work you put in mathematics, it will yield you better when compared to other options. That's my view. Have you got the point? So that is more yield, good yield of hard work. Whatever hard work you have put it will yield you good score. More scoring is there. Whereas in other options, it's not possible. Yes. Self-assessment. This is possible only in maths optional. No other optional have the self-assessment capacity. After writing exam, I can say, yes, for this question, one step is missing. So I may get one mark less. So I will get 9 out of 10. The next question, 20 marks question. Yes, I wrote fully and whatever theorems used, whatever formula used, I have mentioned there. So I get 20 by 20. Like that, you can assess yourself. Nobody has to assess you. You can assess yourself after writing the exam. That is possible only in maths optional. In other options, even though how beautifully you present it, I am not sure that nobody has presented more beautiful than me. Then only I will be selected. Am I right? Here it is competition. But in mathematics, it is a specific answer. That answer cannot be expanded. More beautifully, nobody can write. That is a specific answer. Nobody can expand it, nobody can shrink it. So that is possible. Self-assessment is possible only in maths optional, not in the other optionals. So in these factors, do you agree with me or any controversies there? If you have any doubt, yes, please. Yes. Somebody wanted to talk, but he is not. So this is, these are the what benefits of taking optional mathematics. If you are agreeing with that and you are having interest, then you can opt for maths. Any other thing you want to add? Anything you are declining it? Any point? What I have explained is wrong?
No, sir.
Okay, right. then comes how to prepare for maths. See, preparation of optionals, preparation of subject is different for different optionals. If you want to prepare in the process of your what, how you are preparing for GS, I want to prepare for mathematics also in that way only, then I don't suggest. Preparation of mathematics option will be in a separate way, different from your GS preparation, different from other options preparation. Okay. See, we have a famous writer, M.L. Khanna. Have you heard his name? He has written thousands of mathematics books. M.L. Khanna. Whatever your graduate syllabus, entire three-dimensional geometry, vector calculus, whatever you want, everything is written by M.L. Khanna in our days. In his every book, he put a heading like this. Don't read this. That is the page heading. He puts a heading like that. That's what he told. Never read mathematics. Always adopt pen and paper for doing mathematics. So without pen and paper, you should not touch mathematics preparation. Always you should be attached with pen and paper. You have to adopt the pen and paper. You have to work. You have to write. See, otherwise you will be simply deceiving yourself. So in mathematics preparation, this is the first point to be noted down. Comfortably, I am lying on the bed and I am writing the formulae. No use. Like novel reading, I am viewing the answer. That answer is done by me only. That's why I am referring it. No use. Always you have to adopt pen and paper. You have to practice it. Then only you will get it. You will never be able to reproduce the solution of a question in the examination unless or until you have done it earlier in writing. Always you have to write in writing. You have to answer the question in writing. Then only it is possible to answer in mathematics. If you don't want to write and I will prepare just like GS only, I want to prepare like that only, then I don't suggest mathematics. If you want to prepare for mathematics, this should be followed. You should never read it. You have to write it. Always you have to solve it. You have to write the answer. Even though it is known to you, write it. Once again, you solve it. You have to solve by pen, not by viewing. Okay? See, even in interview also, so many interviews also, whenever they are asking questions on mathematics, they will provide pen and paper. If the interviewer knows about the mathematics, then immediately he will supply pen and paper, even in the interview also, in most of the company's interviews also. Whenever he is asking for any mathematics question, he will definitely provide a pen and paper. Like your computer programming. Suppose you want in any other interview, he want a program for any other problem. Then how can you tell it? You have to write it and give him. In a similar way, mathematics preparation should be always adopt a pen and paper. Never try to read it. That should be the first thing. Okay? Then, first you have to maintain a class notebook. This class notebook I named it, but even homework, whatever given in the class also, you can do it in the same. I can call it as running notes, or dictated notes, or prepared notes. All the things you can put only one notebook, that's enough for each subject. You can continue whatever you are learning in the class, you can have it. Whatever homework is given, that also can be added. Whatever practice you are doing, that also you can have in the same book. That is class notebook. That is notebook number one. Every day, whatever you have learnt on that day regarding mathematics optional, immediately before going to sleep, you have to note down the crux. Crux means whatever definitions are there, whatever theorem statements are there, whatever problems are there in that, no solutions, only problems. That you have to prepare write in a separate notebook. It is called formula notebook. never postpone that formula notebook noting even a single day also. Whatever today I have prepared from morning to evening, whatever time I have spent with mathematics preparation, either in the class or in the house or in the library, wherever it is, finally before going to bed, today's from notes you have to write down what are the definitions and what are the problems, what are the theorem statements. No solutions, no proofs. Like that you have to prepare it. For practicing you may prepare in other book, but in the same, the whatever you have learned in the day before going to sleep, you have to write it daily. So daily you have to use two notebooks, class notebook and formula notebook. This is how to prepare with mathematics optional. Okay, then previous year questions, subject wise, year wise, compact answers. Previous year questions, three types are given: subject wise, year wise, compact answers. That means this previous year questions, for that you have to keep three notebooks different from these two. Whatever class notebook is there, whatever formula notebook is there, that are separate. Separately you have to keep previous year previous questions notebook. For that, what you have to do is you should never touch within the chapter. Once a subject is over, suppose I have taken up numerical analysis and computer applications. So once numerical analysis and computer applications is over, while doing numerical analysis, while preparing for numerical analysis, you don't try to solve the previous year questions. Don't try it at the same time. After completion of numerical analysis and computer applications, then you have to try the previous year questions. That questions also only in that chapter. So for that a separate notebook. Only in that chapter, whatever previous questions are there, for that you have to maintain a separate notebook. And whatever at least minimum start from 2020, from 2022 at least 5 to 6 years, 8 years, 7 years, what depending on your capacity, depending on your time, from latest to old. Like that you prepare for, you write the question and answer. And that answer, while writing the answer in the subject wise, is you have to write each and every definition, each and every theorem proof, each and every theorem statement. Don't try to compact it. It's not in the examination, it is your preparation. So while writing the first notebook for previous questions, you have to write expanded answer. Write from the very definition whatever you're using. Suppose you are using a definition there, you have to write that definition. You are using a formula there, you have to derive that formula. You are using a theorem there, you have to prove that theorem. So automatically what happens, it is nothing but a revision. I have named it as previous year questions, subject wise. So once one subject is completed, preparation is completed, then you have to write whatever questions asked in the previous questions. But while writing answers, in the elaborated way you have to write, not like in the exam. This is for your preparation. So in the elaborated way you have to write. This is to be done while preparing first time. This is to be done while preparing first time. Once one subject is over, immediately previous questions in that subject. Each question, you write it, after that answers. While writing answers, whatever definition you are using, you define it separately again. Whatever theorem you are using, prove that theorem. Whatever formula you are using, derive that formula. Like that you have to prepare the question. Next, year-wise, not now. Year-wise previous questions answers is not now, not in the first time preparation, in the time of revision after your prelims exam is over. So previous year questions, three notebooks I told you. First notebook, it is nothing but your revision come preparation of answers to the previous year questions. But other two books, after exam, after prelims exam, while preparing for mains, then you have to write this year-wise. That means 2020, it's not subject wise now. From question 1 to question 8, all questions answers you have to prepare. While preparing this also elaborately only. Again elaborately only, that means it is nothing but second revision. So preparing for answers for previous questions year wise is to be done not now. It is after your prelims exam is over. While preparing, while revising, while preparing for mains, then you have to write year wise. Here also you have to write complete answer, comprehensive, complete you have to write, not compact answers. Then third notebook is there. Previous questions, compact answers. Now you have to write the answer. How you have to write in the exam only. That means time constraint, space constraint. Both you have to keep in your view. By taking the time constraint and the space constraint, now you have to prepare the answer as if you are writing in the exam. That is also to be done after prelims is over. So while doing these things, that is previous year question subject wise, your formula notebook will be very familiarly you can use it. Whatever definition is there, you need not search for definition in the big notebook. Your formula notebook will give you. Whatever theorem you are using, the theorem is there. By seeing the theorem in the formula notebook, the answer should come to your mind. Then now prove it. Like that you have to prepare year wise. So revision will be like this. So previous year questions year wise, previous year questions compact answers. Like that if you revise it, it is enough. This is the procedure of preparation of mathematics. So while preparing first time, what you have to do? Class notebook, which contains each and everything of daily. Whether you prepare in the class, you prepare in the house, you prepare in the library, whatever is there. Repeatingly you are processing, you can use a rough book. So whatever required, complete syllabus will be there, complete subject will be there in this class notebook. Then formula notebook, day-to-day updation, never postpone it. Same day you have to update the formula notebook. Never postpone it. Then only it will be useful to you. Then only you can do it. Sometimes I observe so many students, after completion of chapters I will write so that it will be useful for division also. No, it cannot be done. I am sure. With the experience of previous batches I am telling you. Formula notebook should be updated day to day. After completion of one subject, then go for previous year questions. In that subject only. Prepare elaborate answers. Complete big answer you have to prepare for each and every question. Not like exam. Whatever definitions, whatever theorem proofs, whatever formula derivations, everything you have to write. Like that you have to prepare the answer. So that for revision, it will be more useful. Previous year questions, if you see, what is the entire subject will come to you automatically. Next year wise, this is after prelims exam, not now. Year wise and compact answers. So like this previous year questions, for previous year questions answering only, you have to keep three notebooks separately. Don't club it. So this is the way of preparation for mathematics for better results. Okay? Any doubt in this? Everybody agrees with that? Don't think that it takes more time. No. Your normal preparation, whatever you are using rough book, at the same time, you can write your previous answers also. It won't take much time. Adopting the way of answering of top rankers, then you go for. Normally what happens is, our tendency is, suppose you have seen a question, previous year question. In the internet, everything is available. How the answer, how this is answered with the top ranker? Let us see, let us search. Yes, it will be available. Then you try to practice it, but you cannot understand it. So it will lead you to decrease your practice, first of all. So don't go for adopting your top answer before these three persons. Before these actions, then you go for how the previous candidates have answered, how the top rankers answered it. There you should not follow them. You have to modify it for betterment. This is already evaluated. So it is to be further ratified. You have to add it. Like that you have to prepare. Okay? Then classifying most asked to least asked topics. Now you have to classify. Never classify before preparation. If you classify before preparation itself, one topic it is less asked, less answered. While preparation itself you will be having mind in the mind, it is less answered. It is less. It is not having most priority. So automatically you cannot prepare for that at all. So after, you see, all these things are step by step. No advancement or backward. Step by step you have to follow this process. Then only you will be successful in preparing for mathematics. You have to adopt this process. Then it will be more useful and it will yield you more rank, more score. So then you can classify. That is for further studies. Suppose some question is there. For example, in differential equations, one topic is there. Cauchy's characterization method. That method is easy, but it takes minimum 2 pages to answer, and time also minimum 20 minutes. Such questions you have to give less priority. Can't but position only you have to answer that. Otherwise you can skip it. But while preparing you cannot skip it. Why? Because each and every topic will be covered in the compulsory questions. 2 questions are compulsory, you know it, for each paper. Question number 1 and question number 5 are compulsory. And in that question, each and every subject will be covered with 5 bits. 5 sub-questions will be there, each 10 marks. So all topics will be covered in that 5 questions. All subjects will be covered. So you cannot leave any subject. Choice is for only questions, not for the subjects. So like that, while preparing itself, you never try to find out what is most asked, what is least asked. No. After preparation is everything is over, then for further studies to research it, then you think of this. What is most asked topics? Then you do research in those topics. That will yield you more better results. Is it clear regarding the process? Any doubt? Any hardship in this process? Do you find any hardship? Yes, tell me. Free and frank, you can tell it. No problem. Is it clear?
Yes, sir. Is it clear? Sir, from previous year question papers, how much marks can we expect it?
What is that? From?
From previous year questions, since the syllabus is static, same questions only, it may repeat. No, sir, how much we can expect, how much percentage?
Sir, frankly speaking, same questions will not be repeated. Same type of questions will be repeated. Okay. Okay, sometimes you may find the same question also, very rarely, but same type of question will be there. If you clear off minimum 7 to 8 years previous papers, then automatically the same type of questions you will find in your new paper also. Is it clear?
Yes, sir. Clear, sir. Thank you.
Right, right. Then how we help you? Here I help you. That's all. I cannot read before instead of you. You have to prepare. Okay? Regular coaching program. That's what we are going to start within a few days. That is a regular coaching program. In this regular coaching, what will be done? And next, rapid revision program. This will be given only after your prelims exam is over. There, rapid revision will be there. We take maximum 30 to 40 days to revise the entire thing. But while revision, I don't mention any answer. What is the procedure? What are the definitions required for that? What is the procedure to answers? Like that, we don't answer all the questions. Answering questions cannot be possible in revision. Rapid revision will be a brush up type. While you are preparing, while you are revising, that rapid revision will be helpful. Next is test series. These 3 types of courses we want to conduct. First, at present, it is regular coaching. So regular coaching, how we adapt. This is the process what I adopt generally. Clear explanation of basics. Yes. Basics, actually, it won't be asked in the exam. But without basics, we cannot learn further. That's why conceptually, whatever basic is there, that will be clearly explained to you, even though it won't carry any mark. But without that, you cannot proceed further. It's not any other subject to mug up the answer. The procedure you have to know. To know the procedure, the basic concept should be there. Basic definition you should know. Without knowing what is a rational number, how can you do the multiplication and division of fractions? Can you do? But if I ask what is the rational number, so many members will not say what is the answer. But of course, we learn it. So we give preference to clear explanation of basics first of all. Why? Because without basics, I cannot proceed further. Any mathematics cannot be done without basics. So basic definitions, basic theorems, whatever theoretical is there, whatever formula is there. Of course, formula derivations, so many derivations we will skip off. Why? Because they are not being asked. Wherever it is not being asked, we will skip off it. Wherever it is asking, we'll explain the derivation also. Okay? Then conceptual approach. So concept wise, first of all, what is the concept in that? Only mere answering the question will not help you. Why? Because same question you will never get. Same type of question you will get it. So unless you know the concept, you cannot answer that question. Same type of question will be there. Same question will not be. Normally, we won't get the same question. Okay? Then sharing of notes. There is no pre-prepared notes for a mathematics option like other options. If I prepare it, print it, and give it also, it won't be useful to at all. Why? Because the very first fundamental rule is never read this. Never read this. So if you are not supposed to read it, what is the purpose of giving a printed notes? You have to work out, you have to write it. Then only you can prepare. That's why sharing of notes means only I will dictate in the class. Whatever necessary definitions are there, I will dictate it definitely. Like 10th class and 8th class student, how I dictate, in the similar way, I will dictate it to note down. No problem. But the only thing is, printed notes sharing will not be done in mathematics optional. It won't be helpful also, what I feel is. If you want to printed material, it will be available in the internet. Whatever you want, whatever topic, whatever question you want, it will be available also. But it won't help you. Unless you write it with your own hand, with your on your own wrapper, then only you will be able to answer it. That's why I don't believe for providing any paper, any notebook. At the same time, I'm very lazy to prepare any notes. That's why I never prepared any notes. So whatever notes is there, that will be given in the classroom automatically then and there itself. I never prepared any notes, and I am not believing that also. That's why I never prepare it. Okay. Then both online and offline classes. Okay, as far as possible, if the COVID permits us, we'll be in offline. Whoever is not available, not even local also not permitted, or if you want to learn it from other sites also, online classes will be definitely there. Offline, if it is permissible. Normally, I don't think so. Even this academic year also, I think online only will be available. As per the situation, whatever it is allowing. Okay, let us hope for the better. If possible, we can have offline also. Otherwise, online will be compulsorily there. Okay. Then scoring-wise priority. Okay. We will analyze in which subject, what is the scoring, what type of questions are being asked. That part we will take care. At the same time, while giving you the answer also, how to answer that question. See here, especially in optionals, the problem is management of two constraints. What are they? While answering the question paper, two constraints are there. What are they?
Time.
Yes? Time. Yes?
Space.
Space.
Speed.
Time constraint and space constraint. Both will be there. So sometimes what happens, the answer will be only three steps answer will be there, but a half page space will be available. That means the examiner is expecting half page, not three steps. Within three steps, I can answer it. But if you answer it within three steps, he won't give full marks. So whatever required definitions, whatever required formula is there, that also to be provided there. That's why he has given that space. So how to manage that space? How to expand in such questions? Similarly, if I answer one question with all providing with all inputs, then the space is not sufficient. He will give one page and it will come two pages. There you have to shrink off. That means you need not prove, just you state it enough. So where statement is to be given, where proof is to be given, that also will be discussed. Depending on the question and depending on the space constraint, how to manage the space constraint, how to manage the time constraint. Paper, sir? Papers, they won't give you question booklet separately, answer booklet separately, they won't give you in optionals. They will give only one book, which contains question, space for answer, question, space for answer. Like that they will give. Advantage in that is we don't miswrite. Suppose question book is separate, answer is separate. I am writing answer for third question and putting four there, which will yield you 0 marks. That will not be available there. Automatically question booklet and answer booklet is same only. Like that they will provide. For each and everything, the space will be there. So in that space only, how to write. Okay? Clarification of doubts. Normally, then and there itself, the doubts will be clarified. Suppose while you are preparing, you get that doubt. While preparing, I will get a doubt. But after coming to the class, some doubt is there, but I don't mind it. I don't remember it. So whenever you get a doubt, immediately you mail me. Or you WhatsApp me. Or put in the Telegram. Definitely whatever queries I get, within 24 hours, I will answer. Why I am telling is, see, normally while preparing, I get a doubt. Next day, by coming to the class, meanwhile, I have done so many things, I will forget it. After 2 days, I got some doubt. But what is the doubt? I don't remember. Such situation will be there. So to avoid such situations, I will provide you my mail ID, at the same time WhatsApp, at the same time Telegram. Through that also, you can pose the question and I will answer it. If it is necessary for all the entire class, I will discuss it in the class. If it is for personally, then I will provide a personal answer. Like that, doubt clarification will be there. Normally, while in the class itself, whatever doubt is there, I will then and there, I will clarify it. Sometimes I may not clarify on the same day. I have to refer, I may need to refer also. Why? Because, see, here preparation is necessary for you, not for me. Am I right? I am telling you any subject means, after the subject is over, I need not practice. Why? Because I need not write the exam. So once again, I have to answer you means, I have to refer it once again. Sometimes it may be possible. So whenever you pose a question, if it is not answered, normally most of the doubts will be clarified in the class itself. If one or two is remained, then I will refer and tell it. See, while learning, I should not feel any shame. I am ready to learn even from the first class kid also, if I don't know the subject. Like that, you have to prepare. If prepare not only this, anything, whatever in your life, if it is to be learned, you never feel ashamed to learn from the youngers also. Never feel afraid to ask any elder also. Then only you can prepare well. So whatever doubts are there in the class itself, it will be clarified. Otherwise, you get a doubt in the while preparing at the house, you can mail me. Then I will provide the answer also. Like the doubts clarification will be done. Then comprehensive coverage of entire syllabus. Definitely, entire syllabus will be covered. I told you 6 to 7 months. Normally, I plan it for 22 to 23 weeks, but it will expand definitely for 28 weeks, 26 to 28 weeks. First, I plan 22 weeks, 23 weeks. Even institute also tells, sir, don't expand it so many times. But when the necessity is there, see, I never be hurry in completing the syllabus. I will be definitely see that entire thing is knowledge is input to you. At the same time, you are ready with the knowledge, provided you are daily following. Suppose you are absent for 1 week and then tell that, sir, it's not covered. No, I can't help. Okay, of course, the recorded may be available for your immediate reference. So like that, I will try to complete entire syllabus definitely. Most of the things will be skipped. Why? Because, see, entire syllabus, if you want to complete each and every step means it will take minimum 3 years. Why? Because BSc 3 years or BTech for BTech syllabus, whatever it is there, entire syllabus is there for you. So if I want to teach the same subject for the graduates who are studying graduation, I will have 3 years time for me. For BSc student, I want to teach it. I can leisurely teach him for 3 years. Whereas it is to be cleared within 6 months maximum. That's what I'm trying. So by taking care of whatever is necessary for the examination, whatever necessary for content. Content should not be disturbed. At the same time, complete concept will be known to you. The procedure should be adaptable to you. At the same time, it should be useful for the question, answering the questions also. So keeping in that view, everything will be syllabus. Every syllabus will be completed. Then more examples will be provided. more questions will be, exercises will be given to you. You have to answer them. Then more practice questions I will provide you, or you can select from different questions also. Whatever doubts you are arising out of our practice questions also you can raise. I am ready to answer them. Then coverage of previous year questions. Almost of the times I will try to coverage, but normally in the routine class I wantedly I avoid previous questions. Why? Because I will give time to you to provide, to think of previous year questions. Then after that I will try to cover that. Okay. Time to time assessment. Once one subject is over, then I will try to put a test in that, so that you will know at what level you have learnt. I don't say weekly test or bi-weekly test like that. I don't announce. Only thing, one subject is over. Altogether, how many subjects we are having in mathematics syllabus? 13 subjects.
9 subjects, sir.
13 subjects. Both two papers put together, 13 subjects are there. We'll come to that also. Okay. Right. So in those subjects, in the sense, okay, if you say ODE, PDE and everything as a calculus only, then it may be one subject. Like that you may think of. Right. So I divide it into 13 subjects only. So minimum each and every chapter after each and every subject is over, I will conduct a test to know where you are for your self-assessment also. Okay. And how to write compact answers. First you learn with elaborate answer only, then how to write compact answers also we will discuss, so that the space constraint and time constraint can be avoided in the examination. For that purpose, I will do that. So this is what we are doing in our regular coaching stream. Yes, is it enough or anything you suggest which will be helpful to you? That also I am ready to adopt. If you think any other thing which can be adopted, you suggest me, I will try to adopt that also. This is the process what I planned. If you want to add anything, you are welcome. Yes?
Sir, how you will teach online, sir? Whether you will write on a board or you will just...
Online, maximum part I will provide you through PowerPoint by step. Why? Because my writing is so beautiful that nobody can understand it. Okay. That's why I'll try to provide through PowerPoint, so that step by step it will be clear to note. If something is necessary to solve it, I will use whiteboard, not this electronic board, normal board. I will make use of that. That also will be done. At the same time, PowerPoint will be done. At the same time, whiteboard in the system also will be make use. So three types of writings will be there. One is PowerPoint, another is whiteboard in the system, and physical whiteboard also. Three methods I will adopt wherever it is necessary, wherever it is feasible. Okay?
Yes, sir. Daily, how many hours should we attend, sir?
2 hours. 2 hours is my session daily.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Right. Yes, any other things you want to add here so that I can adopt it for your betterment? Offline, if it is possible, we are ready. That I am telling. See, if the circumstances allow us, sufficient number of students are there in the class, that also should be there. And then we are ready for offline classes also, no problem. Most of the students think that online mathematics is not so easy, but see, for online mathematics, I also started only last year only. Before that, I don't know how to teach online also. But the circumstance taught me. And the previous batch is very much satisfied. I don't want to bluff it, but they are very much satisfied in online also. As if it is offline only, sir, as it is, I will be able to follow you. Sometimes what happens, when I am providing through PowerPoint, then they wanted, sir, step by step proof is I require. Then immediately I stop the PowerPoint and use a whiteboard. Like that, I will help you. I am sure, right? Because last year, the entire batch is run through online only. There is no possibility of offline class. So last year online class experience is very useful. At the same time, it is very equivalent to not less than our offline. That is there. That much I am sure. no problem. You can fill it as offline, online, like offline only. Only thing is, whatever device you are using, depending on that, the clarity will be there. Suppose you are using mobile to view the class, then automatically it will strain you. If you are using a system or a laptop, then it will be very comfortable to you. If you are connecting to TV, it will be more comfortable to you. So it depends on the device. But of course, only thing is human touch is missing. But of course, I never allow any student like today to keep quiet. Whatever, whenever I am teaching it, whatever I am talking, in that at least 20% of the time, students has to talk. Like that only I teach, even through online also. That is my way of teaching. Otherwise, you will be sleeping. That is the problem. At least offline, I will know who is sleeping, who is not sleeping. But online, the video will be off. So whether he is sleeping or listening, I don't know. That's why I used to ask the questions. Compulsory, they will be awakened. No problem. Even online also, you can feel it as offline only. Yes, any other things you want to add so that it will be more useful? If you suggest anything, I am ready to adopt it.
Sir, can you increase the duration from 2 hours to 4 hours and make a preparation duration lesser, sir, from four months only you can make from 6 months, no?
Okay, I don't have any objection to teach for 4 hours also. But the same thing, the question is, daily 2 hours itself is, you feel hard to spend while learning mathematics. Continuously 2 hours, after 2 hours, you cannot absorb the subject, first of all. That is there. Beyond 2 hours, you cannot absorb it, I am sure. If necessity is there anywhere, someday, some 10-15 minutes extending, that is different. But normally, after 2 hours, you cannot absorb it. For me, even 2 hours or 4 hours, it's nothing. Right? Because I need not again prepare for that. Once I told you, means that's enough. So for me, no objection, but it's not possible for you only. Okay? That is our previous experience also. Even offline also, beyond 2 hours, no, the class cannot be stretched. It will never go to the mind, first of all. That is the thing. Continuously 2 hours working with mathematics itself is hard. Beyond that, it cannot be, it is not suggested at all. That's what I feel. Do you agree with me?
Hello, sir.
Yes.
Can I speak Telugu, sir?
No problem. I can understand Telugu.
Okay. Sir, if optional, I'm table of this work, sir. Sir, Telugu.
Optional?
Optional, I ask paper. I'm Telugu of this work, sir. I'm Telugu medium bathroom.
Optional Telugu medium, no, mathematics.
Yes, sir.
నాకు తెలుగు మీడియంలో నేను చదివాను కానీ తెలుగు మీడియంలో ఇప్పుడు చెప్పడం కష్టం.
నేను ఇంగ్లీష్ మీడియం తీసుకున్నా, తెలుగు మీడియం మేబీ డౌట్స్ ఉంటే కొన్ని అంటే కొన్ని వర్డ్స్ సరిగా రాయలేకపోతారు వాళ్ళు, సో మీకు అది అర్థం కాదు. ఇంగ్లీష్ లో తీసుకోమంటే తీసుకున్నా సార్,
కానీ యాక్చువల్లీ నాకు ఇంగ్లీష్ ఎస్పెషల్లీ మ్యాథమెటిక్స్ ఆప్షన్ లో తెలుగు మీడియం కంటే ఇంగ్లీష్ మీడియమే సుఖంగా ఉంటుంది. ఎందుకంటే నేను తెలుగు మీడియమే, తర్వాత ఇంగ్లీష్ మీడియం, రెండు తెలుసు నాకు. ఈవెన్ డిగ్రీ తెలుగు మీడియం కూడా నేను టీచ్ చేశాను ఆల్రెడీ, బట్ తెలుగు మీడియం కంటే ఇంగ్లీష్ మీడియమే సుఖంగా ఉంటుంది మ్యాథ్స్ ఆప్షన్ వరకు.
ఓకే సార్, కాకపోతే నేను తెలుగు మీడియం బ్యాక్గ్రౌండ్, సో అది నాకు కొద్దిగా కంఫర్టబుల్గా ఉంటాయి.
యాక్చువల్గా కాకపోతే ఒక రిస్ట్రిక్షన్ ఏమొచ్చిందంటే, మీరు మెయిన్స్ లో ఏ మీడియం ఆప్ట్ చేస్తే ఆ మీడియంలోనే అన్ని రాయాలి, జిఎస్ కానీ మెయిన్స్ కానీ మొత్తం అన్ని అందులోనే రాయాలి. తప్ప ఆ జిఎస్ తెలుగు రాస్తాను, మ్యాథ్స్ ఇంగ్లీష్ రాస్తాను అంటే ఒప్పుకోరు.
ఓకే సార్, అయితే ఇక్కడ వచ్చేసి మ్యాథ్స్ ఏంటంటే
కన్వర్ట్ చేయడానికి మీరు కన్వర్ట్ చేసుకోవచ్చు, అది పెద్ద ప్రాబ్లం కాదు. ఎందుకంటే మ్యాథ్స్ లో మీడియం ప్రాబ్లం పెద్ద అవ్వదు.
ఓకే సార్, అయితే ఇక్కడ వచ్చేసి మ్యాథ్స్ ఏ విధంగా ఉందంటే సార్, మేము యూపీఎస్సీ లో కొద్దిగా వేరే అంటే వెక్టర్ స్పేస్ అని, మ్యాగ్నెట్ స్క్వేర్ అని, లీనియర్ అని కొన్ని వాటి కూడా కొత్త ఉన్నాయి సార్. అవి నేను చూస్తే కూడా నాకు అంత స్పాట్ లో గుర్తు రావు, అంత ఐడెంటిఫై చేయలేను. సో ఆ విధంగా నేను అడుగుతున్నాను.
యాక్చువల్లీ తెలుగు కంటే కూడా ఇంగ్లీషే మీకు ఈజీగా ఉంటుంది ఇఫ్ యూ అబ్జర్వ్ బోత్ ద థింగ్స్.
ఓకే,
టెర్మినాలజీ కూడా తెలుగులోనే ఈజీ, ఇంగ్లీష్లోనే ఈజీ. ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ లీస్ట్ అప్పర్ బౌండ్ ఎల్యూబి ఈజీగా రాస్తాం, బట్ కనిష్ట ఎగువ వద్దు అనాలంటే చాలా కష్టం.
ఓకే సార్
అది దానికంటే ఈ సబ్జెక్ట్ బోండి ఈజీగా ఉంటుంది
ఓకే థాంక్యూ సార్
రైట్ రైట్ ఓకే ఫర్ నాన్ తెలుగు పీపుల్ హు డజంట్ నో తెలుగు ప్లీజ్ ఎక్స్క్యూజ్ మీ ఐ హావ్ టు ఆన్సర్ ఇన్ తెలుగు ఓన్లీ వెన్ హి ఆస్క్డ్ ఇన్ తెలుగు దట్స్ వై ఐ ఆస్క్డ్ ఐ ఆన్సర్డ్ ఇన్ తెలుగు ఓన్లీ ఓకే రైట్ ఎనీ అదర్ థింగ్స్ యు వాంట్ టు యాడ్ ఇన్ దిస్ ప్రాసెస్ ఇఫ్ సంథింగ్ ఈజ్ యాడెడ్ విల్ బి మోర్ బెనిఫిషియల్ దెన్ యూ సజెస్ట్ మీ ఐ ఐ ఆమ్ రెడీ టు అడాప్ట్ ఆల్సో దిస్ ఇస్ హౌ అవర్ రెగ్యులర్ క్లాసెస్ ప్రోగ్రామ్ విల్ బి దేర్ ఇఫ్ యూ వాంట్ టు యాడ్ సంథింగ్ ఇన్ దట్ ఐఎమ్ రెడీ టు యాడ్ if you feel sufficient is okay are anything sir, to be removed yes yes
sir can you suggest me subject wise books
yes yes definitely I will come to that also
okay sir
so this is how our regular classes will be done this is how I plan if you want any if you suggest any other thing which is more useful to you then I am ready to adopt that also okay then coming to syllabus so paper 1 section a how many questions will be there in each section 4 questions first question is compulsory and remaining 3 questions also minimum 1 question should be adopted 1 question should be selected see question number 1 and 5 are compulsory and after that 3 questions are to be written but 3 questions cannot be selected from a single section at least 1 question should be selected one other question should be selected from each section so minimum 2 questions are to be done in each section first question is compulsory so first question section a paper 1 section a calculus linear algebra analytical geometry so in this what are new to you
old only everything sir
linear algebra engineering students linear algebra is there to some extent it is there yes, some sir. Matrices and all but the vector spaces and all some theory part is there that is not there in engineering for degree bsc graduates it is there in linear algebra you will be having rank of a matrix and solution of solutions through matrices all these things will be there but vector spaces and all will not be there in engineering so for them some theoretical part is there okay analytical geometry here it is only 3d geometry analytical geometry is only 3d okay then paper 1 section b ordinary differential equations vector analysis here they are saying vector analysis but it is only vector calculus only is there in the syllabus only vector calculus starting from divergence and curl up to stokes theorem okay then dynamics and statics this is a new subject physics okay dynamics and statics so this is a new subject in paper 1 so all together 6 papers will be there 6 subjects will be there in paper 1 among them completely new is dynamics and statics but of course students it is very easy dynamics and statics for mechanical engineering background that is very easy even for bsc people who have studied maths and physics and chemistry for physics there also it is easy only engineering stream other engineering streams they have to work hard for this dynamics and statics but of course it is already covered in your first year physics in even in engineering also first year physics paper is there in that it is covered to some extent but not to this level so that will be taken care okay so this is paper 1 section a and section b now paper 2 real analysis modern algebra complex analysis linear programming what are new here
So yes. Linear programming and real analysis.
Linear programming is there. It is nothing but operations research. Your war paper is nothing but linear programming. Your war is there in your engineering. That is nothing but linear programming. It is only it is not of theory type. Of course, real analysis is theory type. Then modern algebra is also theory type, and complex analysis some extent theory. So these are theoretical papers are more in paper 2. Real analysis is the basis for whatever the calculus is there. Real analysis will be theory part is there. That's why we conduct classes both real analysis calculus put together. Combinedly we will conduct the class. The syllabus of real analysis calculus will be completed combinedly so that you will not feel boredom as it is completely purely theoretical like that. Problems also will be there, so you can easily understand that. Okay. Of course, modern algebra is purely theoretical only. Complex analysis to some extent theoretical is there. Then section B, numerical analysis and computer programming. I think this is everybody knows it. Partial differential equations, that also known to you. Mechanics and fluid dynamics. This is physics part. So this is your syllabus actually, section wise. Previously, 5 years back, up to 5 years back, normally from each subject one question will be asked. But nowadays they have stopped it. Every question will have questions from all the subjects. So you cannot leave any subject as a choice. Choice is given to select only questions, not the subject. So while preparing, suppose if you say I am most worried about the physics, that's why I don't want to touch the physics. No. At least minimum 30 marks minimum you have to lose it without answering. Like that it will be there. I am saying minimum. So this is how syllabus is there. So in that whatever theoretical part, whatever practical already touching. So completely new is dynamics and statics, fluid dynamics and mechanics. At the same time, real analysis, modern algebra. Remaining are not new for engineering background. For a degree background, only physics part is new. All others are known to you. The linear programming is nothing but your OR. OR problems, simplex method and all that stuff. So this is the syllabus. Then this is the analysis of previous years. How many marks are asked from 2020 to 2013 I have prepared. From each subject, how many marks are given? I put it total as 400. Why? 8 questions will be there each paper, 8 into 50. So for 400 marks, how many marks are given? Like that it is. So depending on that, how much priority is to be given to each subject, that we can know. And at the same time, why I am giving this analysis is, somebody thinks that, okay, I may leave someone on one subject. Then suppose I want to leave mechanics and fluid dynamics. See, 80, 65, those many marks are asked in each year. So I cannot take chance like that. So never think to leave any subject. You have to prepare complete syllabus. Then only you will be able to touch the paper first of all. Every question is to be touched, every question is to be answered, means each and every topic is to be covered. Then only you will be able to answer it. So that is how this is there. Then preferred test books. Then coming to test books actually, whatever you have learned in your degree, whatever test books you have used in your degree, they are more useful than any other test books. For example, most of the engineering students depend on BS Gravel. Most of the engineering students for M1 and M2, they depend on BS Gravel. Same BS Gravel can be adopted here also. Same type of questions will be there. More number of exams will be available there. Similarly, preferably for any theoretical subject, you always adopt university, UGC prescribed degree syllabus books. Degree syllabus books are there. For example, if you take the Telugu states, AP and Telangana, Telugu Academy books will be there in English medium for graduation. Those books will be more easily adopted. So that is more preferable. Beyond that, for reference, you can have these things. These are for reference. But mostly whatever you have used in your graduation, those books will be dependent. See, for any subject, no textbook I can say it is not useful. Every textbook is useful. Only thing is, for more number of questions, for an easy approach, what books will be preferred, what books can be obtained, like that. So for that, whatever books already habituated to you, that always preferable. In your graduation, whatever books you have adopted, for learning mathematics, that books will be more useful. After that, for reference, you can use any books. So this is what I propose the schedule for 22 weeks, but I am not sure that I can complete within 22 weeks. It may extend further for 4 to 5 weeks. This is how I prepare my schedule. First, which subject I can select, how many weeks it may take. So like that, I have prepared my micro schedule. But normally, in my experience, within 22 weeks is not completed. It will take minimum 4 to 5 weeks additional. So, so in the beginning itself, I told you minimum 6 to 7 months preparation should be there for first time. Okay. And my point is, I will not be any time. I will never feel hurry to finish off the syllabus. I will always try to cover the subject so that it is useful to you. Then only I can say this subject is over. Otherwise, I don't say this subject is over. That is my way of teaching. I won't run around behind the syllabus. Okay, if it is not understood to you, I am ready to spend another hour also for the same topic. If you are easily understandable, I can skip out of. If it is not given, if it is not asked in the exam, I don't go to that proofs. If you are interested, you can go through the proof. If any doubt is there, I will clarify it. Like that, it will be done. Yes, now your turn. What are your questions? You may ask it now. Yes, sir. Saturday, Sunday, normally no classes. But if necessary is there Saturday, I will again ask you to come back. Sunday, definitely no, there will be any class. But of course, if a subject is completed, I put the test only on Sunday. Of course, if it is offline, then I will think of, it is online, I will provide you the paper and to answer it on Sunday. I plan for 5-day week only, but normally it extends to 6-day week, definitely. Depending on the necessity. Yes, any other queries, please? Yes, I
expect. Sir, you told.
Yes, tell me.
Sir, tell you me. Told you have done. Hello.
What is it?
Sir, you told last year you made online courses. No, sir, can we enroll for that?
What is it? Last year I told only online only. Okay.
Can I enroll for that? Is there recorded classes, sir? I will enroll for that only recorded.
Normally, it's not suggestible. What I feel is, see, in the live class only, it will be live. Suppose recorded class, if you are learning, means once again, you are, whatever I told in the beginning itself, don't read this. You are coming to that only. Once again, you are coming to that only. It's not suggestible. But of course, if the circumstances are not allowing you, then you can contact the institution. If they want to provide, they may provide it.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Okay. But I don't suggest it. Why? Because our main aim is don't read this. So if you go, if you follow completely only recorded means, again, you are reading it. So it won't be helpful. Okay, right. Any other queries, please? From online viewers, I have more questions. Yes, tell me.
Sir, can you tell us about the scaling done by UPSC? Like anthropology, sir was telling, like because of scaling, maths students' marks will be reduced, something like that. I did not understand what he was telling, sir.
Achha, you are talking of scaling?
Yes, sir.
Okay, see, normally what happened is options are like this. In these options, in some options, you cannot get. Even by putting entire efforts also, you cannot get more marks. Suppose if I take Telugu language, there is a restriction in language. No language pundit will give you more than 80%. Normally, yes, they will give you 60 to 70% only. Whereas, yes, if you take our mathematics, then if you write it very properly, then they are never meant to give 10% also.
Yes,
so
sir.
What they think is, it is being unjustified by taking options like that, then they use the scaling. But normally, so far, they have never announced what scaling, what is the criteria for that, and what is the rule for that. They have never announced. They say that, okay, this is scaled like this, like that. See, scaling means normally decreasing the marks to some extent, not to the maximum. There won't be many maximum, that more risk for us in scaling. See, scaling is, who is affected scaling actually for getting more score?
Okay.
So you are getting more score means then that scaling will not affect you maximum.
Okay, sir. Okay. So it's like marks won't be reduced so much. Only little is the difference.
Percentage of marks in the written exam, they shrink it to some extent. That's very rare actually. The difference is more. like that. See, they will compare the top marks. Suppose in Telugu literature, top mark is there. Top mark is 70%. In mathematics, top mark is 80%. 70-80, okay, no problem. But if it is 60-80, then it will be unjustified. That's why they wanted to reduce to some extent to 2%, 3%. They may try to reduce it. Or they may try to increase it also in Telugu literature.
Okay, sir.
Like that, the scaling will be done. And up to now, there is no proper formula. And there is nothing is announced properly like this. We are estimating it, that's all.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Right. Any other queries, please?
Sorry, sir.
Yes.
Sir, exam ippudu conduct chesara maybe ante ee week lo ante oka task ayipoyinaka conduct chesara maybe last total ayipoyinaka conduct chesara
only
maths option
internal test total maths option you are saying or internal test
only maths sir only maths
only maths regarding maths optional whenever a subject is completed immediately in that subject we put a test like that minimum 13 topics okay, 13 tests will be done then and there itself by giving some 2-3 days
correction thesis sir
yes
okay and correction kuda apply chesi sir correction
yes correction also I will do it I will ask you to
sir ante each candidate for
I don't prefer weekly test by weekly test like that I don't prefer whenever a subject is completed in that subject I will put a test that is my way of conducting test okay
so mem vinna tarata adi sir mi conduct chesina exam mem suppose ante good no bad rasinappudu meer explain chesaru kada sir manchi gane aa vidhanga emaina chestara ante
ma weak point indi you are talking of discussing the test am I right whatever test conducted
yes, yes. Only discuss the answers not said sir not said
what is your question
only candidate said
what is your question I did not properly
exam rasam ka sir so many candidate
okay
mandi exam rastaru ka sir
so after so writing exam after writing exam
personal ga
definitely I will
emaina ante candidate ku pilchi vallaku em minus point endo ani vallaku okay chestara ani cheptara
yes definitely while correction itself I will tell there I will write there what is the mistake done at the same time if more mistakes are there if any misapprehension is there I will definitely call him and tell him if it is okay. More misapprehension if it is do we discuss in the class I will discuss in the class also like that okay. I will evaluate
inko question sir me okay me ante meeru cheppina ippudu varuku highest score enta sir maths pranga
frankly speaking ippudu varuku nenu last 2 years e cheptunnanu antha mundu cheppaledu last 2 years ento varuku mains lo
okay
adi mains rase varu evaru raala ento varuku now students lo so how can I tell
okay sir
right frankly speaking
okay thank you sir
right okay oka student oka athanu vachadu last year papa adra correct ga appude covid vachindi he has right optional but he got corona
so nenu kuda
he could not attend the test
okay sir lecturer ku nenu kuda chesina sir correct financial problem valla sem prepare aitunna one year back nundi
okay right
okay
yes any other queries please
sir book list
which one yes please
sir can you sir, provide sir, book list
sir pdf for book list
you want the slide
yes sir
sir during graduation I referred Dr. K.S. Chandrasekhar textbook sir will it help for preparation for UPSC sir
the Chandrasekhar is by Astan company I think am I right this is published it is published by Astan company
doctor company I don't know sir but
it is Astan publishers only it is I think yes guys and sir see any textbook whatever you are followed it is quite useful it is habituated for me at the same time it covers yes. The subject only for other examples for more examples you can refer to those questions other textbooks see you I suggest you not to go through so many textbooks always follow one textbook whatever textbook you have you follow that completely after that whatever more is required you go for reference you can refer other textbooks don't go for more number of books and don't be confused that is my suggestion whatever more number of books to be referred that will be done by me
okay sir
okay so I suggest students whatever you are having touch with the subject that textbook is more always useful
ఓకే సార్, థ్యాంక్ యూ సార్.
రైట్
సార్, మీరు డిస్ప్లే చేసిన పీడిఎఫ్ కనిపించట్లేదు సార్, సెండ్ చేస్తారా?
ఎంటైర్ పీపీటీ వాంట్?
అవును సార్.
ఓకే, ఐ విల్ ఆస్క్ ద ఇన్స్టిట్యూట్ టు షేర్ ఇట్.
ఓకే సార్, థ్యాంక్ యూ సార్.
రైట్. Yes, any other questions? Any queries?
Sir, can we do self-study in mathematics?
Yes, if you are quite perfect about each and every topic, yes, yeah, that can be done. Always, not only mathematics, any subject, if you are confident that, yes, I got the knowledge and I got the confidence to prepare, always suggestible.
How much time it can take?
Depends on your knowledge and your hard work.
Maximum time
it will take 6 to 7 months, like our classes only.
Okay sir, thank you.
Right. Yes, any other queries?
Sir, only optional paranga enta sir fees? Maths only optional.
Fee and all you can ask the administrative department.
Okay. Thank you sir. Thank you.
Right. Probably first week or second week. I will provide you my number, my ID, everything. I will provide you. No problem. Yes, any other queries? So how to reach me? This is my WhatsApp number. This is my mail ID. Of course, Telegram, I did not tell. Automatically by number or name, it will come. In these three modes, you can reach me. No problem. That mail ID is also easily understandable. My name is K. Harnath. That's why KHN Mathematics. @gmail.com. For offline. Self-study minimum time depends on your knowledge. Suppose if you are a postgraduate and you are having to in touch with everything and you are already in teaching position, then it may take minimum 2 to 3 months, it is enough if everything is ready. But of course, preparation of these notebooks is necessary. Whatever I told you, the type of notebooks is necessary. I provided you WhatsApp, mobile, and WhatsApp, mail, and Telegram, not a call. Of course, if you want to call, you can call me, no problem. If I am readily available, I can answer. Normally, I don't decline any phone call, but if everybody calls, it may be problem. That's why I gave preferably WhatsApp or mail. Immediately, I will attend, no problem. If something is to be talked, okay, you can talk, no problem. Same number, contact number also same only. Yes. Can I think that no further queries are there? So finally, what is required?
Sir, program yes, fee structure. Discuss,
fee
sir.
Structure, you can ask in administrative department. Please contact administrative department. They will tell you.
Yeah, I contacted ma'am. Did not told.
I will request them to be ready with the fee structure also. From tomorrow onwards, you will have it.
Yes, sir.
So this is what Abdul Kalam says. Confidence and hard work is the best medicine to kill the disease called failure. So if you want to kill the disease, failure, those two are necessary. Confidence and hard work.
Sir?
Yes?
Only option institute lo cheptara sir, lekapothe total oral coaching is there.
I think both are available. Only option also you can join, and entire thing also you can join. That is there available. Okay, you okay, just sir. Talk to the administrative department. They will give you the guidance.
Okay.
Yes, wish you all the best. So if you are ready to work hard, if you are not afraid of mathematics, if you are having interest in mathematics, then I am ready to take up class. Okay. Wish you all the best. Right. Thank you.